Okay, so it's Renee Crosby with A Touch of Mink again, and I have figured out a name, I think. I am the can-be thrifty decorator. Now, mind you, there's nothing wrong with being thrifty. I'm not downplaying being thrifty. However, recycling, reusing, repurposing is a great thing to do. As well, it saves money. Yes, I've had clients who have huge budgets decorating-wise. We're talking $30,000, $40,000, $50,000. That's a lot of money. And that calls for a different level and a different scope of decorating. However, I think the point that's become part of this process here is now that I'm a stay-at-home mom and this is budget-friendly, I have had to dig deep to find ways to do things a little more economically. So through that process is how I've become a little more thrifty in some of my decorating ideas and projects that I take on. So last I left you was this little bush that I had proceeded to start painting with brown. So let me just quickly finish that to show you the new project that we have that I've completed already. But as you can see, this brown pops against this wall and certainly would not have popped like this had it been just that grayish brown. So my project today, actually I started it yesterday, is this fun little bench. My husband loves footstools. And as I redid the living room, I took his footstool out, and so I bought this shoddy piece of wood. It was $10. I painted it blue last night, and then did the top cushion today. And I'm not a shabby chic kind of girl. However, this one I did decide to do a little bit of wearing on it, just because with the kids in here and it being in the living room, I want it to look like it's been here for a while because it probably will get damaged anyway. So this project, I already actually had the fabric. Total, the project cost me $10 for a new footstool. So here's the tools I use. Now, mind you, this is not a video to teach you how to do things. It's to teach you to empower yourself to think of ways to do things. If you want full instruction, don't worry about it. Just hire me. So the first step was sanding. I had to sand the bench so that it would adhere the paint. Then I painted it. Oh, actually, before I painted it, this is my little trick. The glue gun, what goes into the glue gun is wax, of course. And what I did was I put wax wherever I wanted to peel it off to make the wear marks. And you can see, like down here, it's still bumpy because I have not taken off the glue. So I glued on first to the spots where natural wear might happen, and then I painted it. After I painted it, then I peeled off the glue, and this is what's underneath is the nice wood of what I've sanded it to. So it has these natural wear marks looking like it's been around for a while. So I glued, I painted. Then after I painted, I used just general batting. I actually had some old pillows from Walmart. Bed pillows, actually, and took the stuffing out and did the stuffing. And then I had my fabric that I kind of cut in the shape that I needed. And then I staple gunned. Don't buy a plastic one. Buy a nice metal one. I staple gunned the fabric to the underside. And then this handy-dandy little screwdriver. Yes, that's a screwdriver, for those of you who don't know what it is what I used to start the scraping of the glue off of the bench. So anyway, that was my $10 project for a brand new footstool, and it's very comfortable and cute and inexpensive. The can be thrifty decorator. Enjoy.